Hi, this is Dr. Justin here. And today's talk is about why am I getting fat? Why is the food I'm eating going into my fat cells versus going in to build my muscles? Well, this is an important concept known as calorie partitioning. Essentially, is how does our body divvy up and say, hey, some calories you go into the muscles, some calories you go into the fat. This is a great concept, and I have some excellent illustrations to show you what's driving this. But in the end, it all comes down to hormones. So first things first, what's a hormone? A hormone essentially is a chemical messenger. These hormones float throughout our body. We have thyroid hormone, we have maybe glucagon, insulin, testosterone, growth hormone. All of these hormones float throughout the body and they bind into receptor sites. So think of a hormone maybe as a baseball. And the receptor site is the catcher's mitt. So the hormone essentially does not really have a response until it binds to a receptor. So baseball in catcher's mitt, receptor, hormone, then we have what's called a response or a proteomic response. And this creates a reaction in the body. So when certain hormones like estrogen hit a receptor, we have a different response than maybe when testosterone hits a receptor. So that's important to note. So everything that I recommend to help change body composition and help increase your metabolism, and all increasing your metabolism means is to help burn more energy, ideally from fat sources, for fuel. So everything we're recommending on the diet, lifestyle, and exercise side are all around putting your hormones in the best possible scenario so you can burn more fat fuel. So one of the things that we see, essentially, is when patients eat certain foods that are more inflammatory or refined or higher sugars, we are dumping more of our calories that are going, essentially, into the fat cell. And the fat cell is storing those calories out. So if the fat cells are storing these calories in fat and the fat's getting bigger, our mitochondria, or the furnace in our cells, don't really have the access to burn these fuels for energy. So one of the most common things we see as we're storing fat, we're actually becoming very fatigued and tired. We don't feel too well. And we definitely don't want to exercise because we'd much rather be on the couch and watch a movie or do nothing at all. Because when you're tired, it takes energy to go out and want to work out. So when we're eating certain foods like that, we're going to be making more insulin, we're going to be making more cortisol, we're going to be making more or excessive amounts of leptin, and over time, we see the cells become numb to these hormones. The fancy word is known as receptor downregulation or receptor resistance. Maybe you've heard of insulin resistance or leptin resistance, but essentially all that means is the cells become numb to the hormone. And then essentially those fuel substrates go into the fat cell and not to our furnace to get burned up. So on the other side of things, we have calories floating around in our bloodstream. When we make specific hormones such as glucagon, lipoprotein lipase, hormone-sensitive lipase, and epinephrine, we're able to drive more of our hormones into our mitochondria, drive more of our calories into our mitochondria by that hormone response. Our mitochondria can then burn those calories up for energy, and we feel good. Essentially, our metabolism is revved up, we have more energy, therefore we're more likely to want to exercise. So a lot of times what I see exercise is a byproduct of doing the right things in your diet and lifestyle hormonally to give yourself energy. It takes a lot of willpower to exercise when you're tired. So if we create the right environment with what we eat and how our lifestyle is, we're going to have more energy, more of our fuel and calories are going to go into our mitochondria to get burned up, and essentially our metabolism will be healthier, we're going to burn more fat for fuel, and we'll be able to put more muscle on our body and look leaner in tone. I hope this information was beneficial. Any questions, feel free to visit justinhealth.com and or email the office. Thanks. Have a great day.